r/AskReddit. Crime investigators, what's the creepiest unsolved case you investigated that scares you to this day? Worked in forensics 2004 to 2008. Mostly rapes, homicides, and cold cases. Never forgot one where a baby was abused because a burglar threatened to kill the entire family if the parent didn't do it. Wasn't solved before I left and nothing came up on Google, never forgot names. The idea that someone out there free is that fucked up or that someone would make that shit up is so disturbing to me. At my first department, someone was stringing up dogs in the trees behind houses with their throats cut and bled dry. Serial killer behavior. Obviously just killing them to kill them. Worked on that case a couple weeks. But after 4 or 5 dogs, it just stopped and my bosses wouldn't let me work on it anymore with all the real crime going on. I still think it was a future serial killer practicing. I'm a cop but this isn't my case. The FBI believes that over nearly 2 decades a trucker or multiple truckers have been killing women and dumping their bodies along their routes. In 2004 an FBI wonk notices a trend of bodies being dumped along a commercial trucking route in the south and submit it to a crime tracking database. Texas analyst picks it up and they find dozens of identical cases. No leads to this day. No suspects. No convictions. https://www.fbi.gov/news/news/2009/april/highway0real_040609. The Molly Bish case. A 16-year-old girl was dropped off for work at the lake where she was a lifeguard by her mom. She was never seen alive again. This happened in the summer of 2000 in a small town in central Massachusetts. About 30 minutes from where I grew up. I remember seeing missing persons signs all over local business when I was a kid looking for Molly. I don't work in crime investigation anymore. I do animal rescue. But we kept receiving animals found stray that had been sexually abused with sticks and we had to take them in. Help them recover and find new homes. It happened for 2 years straight then nothing. He's either dead, locked up or moved on to humans. Police have DNA but no one has ever been caught or linked to it. Someone was picking up drunk homeless people in my town. About 20 years back. Beating them up and dropping them far from town during the winter season. Which can last for about 2 to 8 months and drop as low as minus 45 Celsius. Edit. Few extra details. It was during the mid-1990s. In the Terrace PGPR area. Not sure if it was police or not. Those that live in a small town only how talk gets around. I remember nothing coming from it. It could have been police or just town thugs. It was just kinda scary for us teens at the time. Mystery was solved a few days after it happened but I figured I would share anyways. In the town I live in there's a rundown motel that all the druggies stay at. Well anyways there was a night that a man walked into and pulled out a sawed-off shotgun and blew the cashier's brains all over the wall. Stole $112 and some change. Obviously our investigation was opened and for 4 days they didn't have any leads or anything. Turns out on the evening of the 4th night they supposedly found the murderer behind the motel in a cornfield in a fetal position just rocking back and forth. Yes. The Texas killing fields. One theory was it was a truck driver picking girls up and dumping them since it's so close at I-45. Sorry I was responding to my other post. I'm just new and this got out of the thread. The 35-pound bags of human vomit that appeared in the PKG lot of the Radnor. Par Bed Bath & Beyond. For a few weeks. The woman on Philly walking to the Acme MKT. Who thought someone ran by and hit her accidentally. She shopped for 30 minutes at Acme. Then walked home and her daughter discovered a chef's knife lodged in her neck. No one at Acme said anything and the knife was visible on surveillance. The case of Missy Bevers. Murdered in 2016 as she waited for the arrival of her yoga class. There's video of the suspect in SWAT gear as they're leaving the scene but they've never been caught. Source. https://www.incitedition.com/family-mourns-mother-stab-bludgeon-death-church-nearly-3-years-ago-50829. Someone had been leaving half-eaten fish all over West London, as Encounter bought fresh fish. Scales and all. It was an ongoing cold case cause the saliva was the same on each one. No one was really victimized by it though, so we never got a chance to properly look into it. I work as an investigator for the County Medical Examiner. The cases that always creep me out are the Jean and John Does. Especially the younger ones. How could a family not report a loved one missing for 10, 20 or 30 years? Some of these cases are not suspicious, so it's not like the family is worried about going to prison. We're looking at forensic genealogy to assist with some of the cases. A local girl went missing about 2 years ago. Whole community and neighboring communities got involved. Had a hashtag they painted on car windows and everything. Tried like crazy to find her. The parents still hold out hope. But I'm not convinced they really do. And it's devastating to watch. I have friends that know the family. I have two young girls. And this is a fear that my job forces me to take home with me. That one day they'll disappear and that's it. There are some sex trafficking hotspots nearby. A week after that girl disappeared, I told my wife she was most likely already dead. Not a crime investigator. But the older brother of someone I went to high school with disappeared in August of 2017. He had gotten into drugs. Went to rehab. And was trying to rebuild his life when he went to Maryland to visit a friend from rehab. When he got there, the friend had made other plans but sent him to hang out with this other woman in her 40s. He was not allowed at the woman's house, so she drove him to a piece of property her uncle owned. Left him there to detox without any food, water or shelter and claimed she would be back soon. She left him there for 3 days. Claimed to drop off supplies, but his parents have their doubt about that. When the parents came a week later, he was gone and the woman claimed to not know where he went. A couple months later his body was found over 100 miles away. His death is being investigated and I believe the state is building a murder case against the woman. I will be following when that happens. Very sad story. If anyone wants to Google it, his name was David Gibson Smith. When I was a kid, a girl in my neighborhood went missing. It was a big thing and everyone searched and searched and found nothing. Then about 3 weeks later the neighbors of the girl called the police. The teenage boy of their family killed the girl and put her body in his waterbed. All the people going missing in federal parks. FBI does not track them. Guesses are 1,600 slash it disappear and some are not found. It happens at an alarmingly high rate compared to other places. Not a criminal investigator, but I do CPS joint investigations. We'll never fully know what one little girl went through as she was very young. She's doing very well now. But she had nightmares for years of a big gray man that would come into her room at night. Horrible case of sexual abuse. Really shook me. Hinterkaifeck murders, 1922 Germany. Creepy sounds in a barn and an entire rural family is slaughtered, including a maid who had just arrived. Evidence at the scene showed that the killer had stayed in the home for several days, lit a fire, and fed the animals. Nothing valuable was taken. My father was a police officer some time ago. While in school, his platoon was called with every other policeman in region. A kid was missing. They were looking for him for quite some time. Yet they did not find him. He was supposed to be somewhere in small forest near the town he was living in. Kid just sunk. After some time, people would contact police and say that kid was seen almost 500 kilometers away, alone. They had many suspects but all got their alibi. The case was open for almost 20 years and was closed like 10 years ago. We'll try to find some info about it, edit post. But here in Poland we do not put such information to public. Edit. I tried to find anything but there's no trace of this accident. I talked with my dad about that. He said that kid was about 9 or SMTH. He went missing in Pomerian Voivodeship in Poland. Sadly, that's all he can remember. Sorry guys. Not me, but my dad told me about this. On the Gold Coast in Australia in the 1990s. There was a Chinese mob. The wife of the leader wanted a new husband and boy toy. The following is all presumed, but she got people in the mob to kill him. She then presumably cut him up with a garden saw. This is based off of neighbors' reports of a chainsaw at 1 a.m. for long periods. It was presumed that she put the body in gym bags and put it next to the bin. A teenager saw the bags and wanted to take them, but he kicked the bags and it was squishy, so he decided not to. When she reported her husband as missing, she was the prime suspect. The police found the bathroom covered in blood using UV light. The body was never found, so it could never be pointed to her. She was convicted on assumptions due to her already affiliation with the mob. She gets released next year from a life sentence. Edit. Newspaper clippings my dad put together. http://imgur.com/gallery/5a10tqi. An Israeli girl, Tyrada, was murdered in her school's bathroom. And this one guy, Roman Zdorov, was convicted. But DNA evidence has shown that someone else committed the murder. You can read more about the case here. Not a crime investigator, but Dairo Aking went missing about a decade ago and was found in boxes. It is estimated that she was cut up into around 2,000 pieces. When they put her back together, they were missing a heart, spleen and liver. My personal theory is black market organ transplants. To sell or to use, I don't know. Maybe to sell, because the heart sells for around $1 million USD on the black market. Back in the early 80s, a 16-year-old boy was walking home from a party about a mile from his house when he was intentionally hit by a vehicle and dragged by the vehicle before being dumped in front of his house for his father to find his body in the morning. The police say they have suspects, but not enough evidence to make any arrests. There are still posters all over the town and surrounding areas with his picture asking for information more than 35 years later. Really a tragic story that needs closure. Edit. This is the Eric Cross case. And I am not an investigator. Just a local. In high school, I knew a girl through mutual friends in our very small town. She was a freshman and I was a senior. The story goes she was walking home around 1 a.m. from a community of trailers about 3 miles from town, and before leaving called her mom for a ride. Mom was a drug addict and refused to come get her. She never made it home. 5-6 years later, I return home from the military and see a newspaper article. Her remains were found wrapped in barbed wire in a canal. The crazy part is that it had to be a local. I know this because where they found her body was a popular swimming spot in the community and was miles from town and on the complete LII opposite side of town from where she was the night she went missing. No one swims there now, and the whole thing is largely forgotten by the community with the exception of those who went to school with her. My friend's mom is a lawyer and she was involved in a case where a teenage girl was raped and murdered in the woods outside a small town with a military base nearby. The person who did it was never found, but a teenage boy was wrongly imprisoned for a few years. There are conspiracy theories that a military officer did it and the government covered it up. I saw a play about it with my friend's family, but I can't remember the name of the town. One of the investigators wrote a book about it that was pretty popular a while ago. Obligatory not an investigator. But this one happened in my province when I was but a wee child, and I've thought about it ever since. Mindy Tran was raped and murdered in Kelowna at 8 years old. And as far as I know, it was never officially solved. Edit. It always scared me as a kid. And even a teen. Since I was only a bit younger than her when she died, and I was afraid to go to parks alone for a long time. https://www.reddit.com/r/unresolved mysteries/comments/4j0na1/the_disappearance_mindy_tran/?utm_source=sam_medium_ampersand_utm_media_medium_contact_post_body. A man from Australia called Mr. Cruel kidnapped a bunch of teenage girls. Did a lot of disgusting things to them, and his last victim wound up dead. My auntie personally knew two of the girls who were kidnapped. He hasn't struck in 20 years and has never been found. For a time, my business contracted to a pie company that was made up of part-time police officers. One case they told me about was a guy who simply vanished. Normal life. Wife. Kids. Active in the community. Gone out of thin air. Over the years, there were verified sightings of him. There is recording of him over a year later at a bar in Omaha. Bartender happened to be from the area where he disappeared and recognized the guy after he left. Best anyone could tell is that he just wanted a new life and successfully started over. This one was pretty local to where I grew up, but someone found a bloody Santeria dagger on the steps of their apartment complex. People were pretty freaked out, and this was a heavy Mexican Catholic area, so it got some attention, but there never was news about why, and the rumor was it was a crazy homeless guy who lived in the area who disappeared after it was found. Not an investigator, but back in the 1960s the Australian Prime Minister went for a swim at a beach in Victoria and completely disappeared. No remains or any evidence of what happened has been found. Presumed drowning obviously, but still creepy that someone like that can disappear completely without a trace. The Philly Burb Suburban Bomber Case. Multiple pipe bombs in bedroom town Phoenixville Par. 3 years. Never solved. Not one myself. But this case shocked everyone. Girl went missing. Pregnant at the time. 36 weeks. Police interviewed everyone. The boyfriend. The other boyfriend. Friends. Mother. Neighbors. Etc. Body was found almost a year and a half later. On a shed. Not 100 yards from her house. The killer tied her up. And buried her alive. All the while she was on labor. Then covered her with concrete. When found, the baby was halfway through the birthing canal. Head already out. Case is still ongoing. They have a suspect, but there is still a couple of years away from anything concrete. My cousin is a medical examiner for Detroit. He's not allowed to do murders, suspicious deaths as he isn't a DR. But his first case was a man about the same age as his dad with the exact same name. The lead medical examiner looked at the chart and said, "Your dad isn't a black pimp, is he?" Know why? Oh good, then it isn't your dad. Not a crime investigator. But I had a good buddy that went missing in a cornfield when he was a 2-year-old kid. Back in 1980 or 81. Literally thousands of volunteers came out to help search the fields and land around his farm for 2 days. But he was nowhere to be found. They even brought in a psychic. His parents were so desperate. On the third day he was finally found. Quite some distance from where he disappeared. His parents still think to this day that he was abducted. But because of all the media attention and people searching for him, the kidnappers returned him. Pretty much just dropping him off and hightailing it out of there. Obligatory not a crime investigator. Richard Cody Haynes has been missing since the 11th of September, 2004. His dad and stepmom were the last to see him alive. He refused to do his chores that night and he was forced to stay in the kitchen until midnight and was then sent to his room. His sisters were told to not go near him. There was a scuffle between Cody and his father's girlfriend, and at 2:30 a.m. his father went on a drive to look for car parts while Cody was supposedly in his room and doesn't return until 4 p.m. the next day. During this time no one checked on Cody, and at 5 p.m. his father filed a missing persons report. His father and his girlfriend lawyered up pretty quickly, and it creeps me out that seemingly nothing is getting done about finding who killed him. I hope his mom gets justice for her son's killer. So my town had the mad pooper. I don't even remember if they actually caught the lady who was shitting on everyone's lawns. Then someone was leaving dildos all over town. But for real unsolved cases. Check out the burning barrels case from my hometown. Now. This town has like 400 people, and the people that live there are either fantastic or barely human. We've had quite a few weird murders and missing people and even some alien abductions. People are nuts. But the burning barrels case is very real and hasn't been solved to my knowledge. And just based on the zero resources that county has, I doubt it will get solved. Spooked the hell out of me as a kid though. There was a case here in Washington State where a young woman was assaulted and murdered. It took 30 years to get the guy. 20/20 just did a story on it. Very sad case, as the dude was living in the same neighborhood all this time. It took a co-worker to help police get his DNA. On my town we found a dead body in the middle of a street. A good neighborhood. Never figured out who was this person since nobody ever filed a missing person for him. Creepy part? He was beheaded. And the head was inside his stomach. Why the actual shit am I reading this at 3 a.m? Not a crime scene investigator. And the case was solved, but it never sat right with me. In my neighborhood, a 30-year-old Russian girl with a mental disability went missing for 7 days. She was then found dead in a park, only partially clothed. She had been set on fire and died as a result of the burns. Edit. It was officially ruled a suicide. My town is more like two small towns and one. They share a school district and are only about 2 miles apart. One is has an abnormally high rate of cases of childhood cancers and is an extreme outlier compared to other towns of the same size or in the region. Environmental specialists came in and tested everything and came up with nothing. The other town is supposedly one of the most haunted towns in the country and creepy shit is constantly happening. There are always reports of ghost activity but again no results. Mindhunter got me weirded out about those Atlanta child murders. Not so much scared. But as someone from Chicago who loves our unresolved mysteries, the Max Headroom broadcast signal intrusion has always fascinated me. It's been over 30 years and we still don't know who was behind that bizarre video. There was a thread a while ago of someone that thought they had figured it out that seemed very possible. But it was updated and they were ruled out as suspects. Here is the infamous video for those that have never seen it. Not an investigator but two guys disappeared out of nowhere. They were both cousins. Their truck was found burning far from where they were last seen and the setup was just weird. I'm friends with their cousins and they said that some of their things were hanging from the bushes and trees. The truck had crashed through a fence, think ranch type of wire and wooden fence in rural Texas, and was left there to burn. It's been a year and some almost two and there's absolutely no trace of them whatsoever. I'm not sure if it's because there really is no evidence or because our DA is a fucking moron, something assume townspeople think because of the amount of time it takes for cases like this to even move. There's also another one in my city where two teachers were murdered in one of their homes, both tied to a chair and each with a bullet in their head. To this day absolutely nothing has come of it. There's a man who comes into the bar I work at every day around 4 p.m. He's nice. Has a group of other guys he socializes with. His wife comes in every Sunday with him for football season. Their daughter went missing a few years ago. They had a suspect, who my older sister actually dated for a short period. When they couldn't definitively connect him to the case, they cut him loose. He's now serving time for a completely separate kidnapping murder. He hasn't confessed to the first one, so the couple will never really know if they caught a guy. Everyone just assumes. I don't think the family will ever get closure off of an assumption though. The Toynbee tiles. Not scary, but fucking fascinating. There is a documentary that has a lot more interesting info. We had a neighbor who killed cats by decapitation and put them in the owner's mailboxes together with a note. He did this more than 50 times. When they found out who it was, they found that he were planning to kill a person and got a couple of years in Yale. He now live alone in a forest somewhere and cannot show himself in his hometown cause everyone know who he is. Anyone remember this famous case where a girl went missing? Looked like she ran away. Her car was found on a highway. Then some guy started uploading YT vids made in a basement of some sort. Playing musical instruments with exact details only the police and the father knew. Along with some things her father said in an interview. The police were never able to identify who the guy was. Not an investigator. The William Terrell case. This is the most famous missing persons case in Australia. A 3-year-old boy named William Terrell went missing from his grandmother's house in 2011 and has never been found. Not even his body. The grandmother said he was there 1 second. She went inside to get something. Then when she came back out he was gone just like that. https://en.m.wikipedia.org/wiki/disappearance_of_william_deal. The unsolved case of John Bonnet. She was a little girl who was murdered in her home and the case was never solved. Someone killed 50 dogs and left them on top of parked cars for a year, then it just stopped. In a town close to me. A few years ago a little boy went missing. He was in a foster home with his siblings. There was apparent previous reports from neighbors of them wandering off frequently because they were left alone without food. Breaking into garages, I think. He was reported missing by the foster mom. She went on TV and everything, I think I remember. There were so many search parties. We live in the desert, so there's a lot of open land. I stopped hearing things about it. Eventually I asked one of my buddies who works in that PD and he told me they never got any real answers. They found remains years later that they believed to be his in a canal. But it had been so long, not much was left. Also, they think wild animals had probably spread what was left of the remains around after all these years. https://weirdnj.com/weird-news/Jeanette-DePalma/. Guy let his dog out and it came back with a decaying limb. When they went to search, they found a makeshift altar. Creepy stuff. Two girls in their 20s round murdered in their car. McDonald's food in their laps. Windows up. Doors locked. No sign of a struggle. Was my last case I ever worked. 3 years ago. No suspects have been arrested. Edit. I was an investigator for the medical examiner. My job was to document facts, not solve the crime. Local law enforcement is responsible for the solving. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for daily awesome videos. Feel free to like the video if you love it, and comment down below for suggestions on the next video.